Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel, and in the video today, we're answering a viewer question. Neil asks, why do we put hydrogen peroxide on our cuts? As a kid, did you ever fear telling your parents that you'd skimmed your knee because you'd fear your mum breaking out a brown bottle of pain containing hydrogen peroxide in order to help heal your wounds? Well, given the agony it caused, you might have wondered whether the fizzing liquid was actually helping, and why hydrogen peroxide bubbles when it comes into contact with your skin. If you're still wondering about that today, well, wonder no more. To begin with, hydrogen peroxide does indeed kill bacteria, viruses, fungi, and a whole host of pathogens, thanks to the fact that it is a powerful oxidizing agent. So, in theory, it seems like a great idea to pour it on a fresh cut in order to help prevent infection. It turns out, however, that while this has been a staple home treatment for cleaning various cuts and abrasions for nearly a century, you probably shouldn't use hydrogen peroxide to disinfect your wounds. To better understand why not, we'll need to look at what hydrogen peroxide is and how it manages to kill microorganisms. Chemically speaking, hydrogen peroxide, which is a naturally occurring molecule within the human body, is two parts hydrogen and one part oxygen, H2O2. The molecule is held together by the two oxygen atoms. As a result of these oxygen molecules having a relatively weak bond, it breaks down rather easily, which potentially introduces free radicals into your system. Left unchecked, this would result in a host of problems within the human body. In fact, because hydrogen peroxide's claim to fame is primarily its great oxidizing effect, up until relatively recently, it was thought that its presence in the body had only damaging effects. However, recent research, such as that performed by the German Cancer Research Center in 2014, was able to show that hydrogen peroxide is an essential chemical messenger, helping the body's cells respond to outside hormones and growth factors. As Dr. Tobias Dick sums up, "We know today that the body's own H2O2 is vital for signal processing in a healthy organism." That said, the level of H2O2 must be maintained in a specific range between 0.05 micromoles per liter and 117 micromoles per liter in exhaled breath and in human fluid. Too much in the effects of oxidation will cause countless problems that can result in cell death, among other issues. Now enter the enzyme catalase, which is found in almost all living things. Catalase circulates throughout the cell, waiting to come into contact with the H2O2 being produced by cellular respiration. Once in contact, it rapidly converts into water and oxygen via two H2O2 molecules becoming two H2O water molecules and one O2 dioxygen molecule. In fact, the catalase is so good at its job that it has one of the highest chemical conversion rates of any enzyme. A single catalase molecule can convert millions of hydrogen peroxide molecules every second. It is this water and oxygen being rapidly produced that results in the fizzing bubbling effect that you see when the hydrogen peroxide comes into contact with the catalase. However, even with this efficiency, residual hydrogen peroxide will remain, allowing your body to maintain the low concentration of hydrogen peroxide required for normal protein signaling while keeping it from reaching toxic levels that can destroy a cell. Like all living things, bacteria, viruses, and many other pathogens have a myriad of chemical reactions taking place within their cells. Just as the oxidizing effect of hydrogen peroxide can ultimately potentially interrupt these processes, it can also do the same to bacterial cells. Thus, if this oxidizing agent is present in high enough concentrations, the result is a halt to normal cellular processes, resulting in the death of the pathogen. So now you might be wondering, why is there a controversy today about whether or not you should use hydrogen peroxide on wounds? As we just mentioned, this oxidizing agent will also kill healthy human cells in sufficient concentration. Beyond this, it's also thought that it may slow down the mechanisms of healing because it interferes with the normal scaffolding processes involved with repairing skin damage. This interruption can also potentially lead to increased scarring. This is all not to mention that if the oxygen gas produced by large amounts of hydrogen peroxide coming into contact with the catalase enters your bloodstream, it can circulate through your body, leading to countless medical problems like heart attack, stroke, or pulmonary embolus. While you might think that this couldn't possibly happen, hydrogen peroxide used as a topical disinfectant has been implicated in several fatal and near-fatal incidents due to this oxygen gas being introduced into the bloodstream. However, as yet, it's not entirely clear how the oxygen is getting there. It may be that excess oxygen enters the capillary beds themselves, or that H2O2, hydrogen peroxide molecules, get absorbed into the bloodstream and then, in such relatively high concentrations, create the oxygen embolus. Whatever the mechanism, the potentially life-threatening complication remains. So, in the end, thanks to the propensity of hydrogen peroxide to cause damage to healthy tissue, combined with the very slight risk of oxygen emboli after pouring it on a cut, the use of hydrogen peroxide to clean wounds is not usually recommended anymore. So, what should you do when cleaning wounds? Well, most doctors will point out that simply using normal saline, a little elbow grease, and some over-the-counter topical antibacterial products will have a much greater chance of preventing infection than the hydrogen peroxide would anyway. So, I really hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. And don't forget to subscribe for brand new videos just like this every day of the week. And I'd also like to take this moment to thank our patrons on Patreon. If you're interested in becoming a patron of Today I Found Out and helping us out with a small financial contribution that helps keep these daily videos coming, please do consider heading over to patreon.com/TodayIFoundOut. There are also loads of cool perks that we're giving away. T-shirts, hoodies, GPS where I read the voice, voicemails, there's like 11 things. I can't even remember them all, but go over and check it out at patreon.com/TodayIFoundOut. And as always, thank you for watching.